الحمد لله رب العالمين حمدا بجميع المحامد على جميع النعم، حمدا لا يتناهى ملء السماوات السبع وملء الأرض السبع وملء ما بينهما وملء ما شاء الله من شيء بعد، حمدا كما تحب يا ربي وترضى ولك العتبى حتى ترضى، ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن سيدنا محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الله به الغمة وجاهد في سبيل الله حق جهاده حتى أتاه اليقين. فاللهم صل على محمد في الأولين، وصل على محمد في الآخرين، وصل على محمد في كل وقت وحين، وصل على محمد في الملأ الأعلى إلى يوم الدين. يقول الحق تبارك وتعالى في قرآنه الكريم: ولا تحسبن الله غافلا عما يعمل الظالمون. الله عز وجل saying in this ayah of the Quran Kareem, never think that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is unaware of what any zalim doing. Never think that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is unaware of any oppressor, of any wrongdoer doing. And I remember I stopped the last time with hadith of Rasulullah narrated by Imam Muslim, while Imam al-Tirmizi 2533 wal-Bayhaqi. When Rasulullah said, do you know who is al-Muflis at the Day of Judgment? Who is the poorest one? Who is al-Miskeen? They said, ya Rasulullah, al-Muflis, the one who does not have dinar or dirham, does not have money. He said, no. من يأتي بصلاة وصيام وزكاة، he come in front of Allah with صلاة والصيام والزكاة with good deeds، حسنات كأمثال الجبال، good deeds and good reward equal to mountains very huge، but at the end he will be thrown to Jahannam. Why؟ يأتي وقد شتم هذا وقذف هذا وأكل ماز هذا وسفك دم هذا وضرب هذا. They come in front of Allah Azza wa Jalla and he curses this one and he insults this one and he backbites this one and he slanders this one and he eats the property and the money of this one unjustly and he killed this one and he beat that one. Then at the day of Qiyamah will be given to those people equal to what he did against them in the dunya from his good deeds. This much to this one, this much to this one. If all of his good deeds finished, then will be taken from their bad deeds, put in upon him, then he will be thrown to Jahannam. We ask Allah to save us. Say Ameen. And I said, Rasulullah said in Muslim with Tirmizi 2533 Ibn Hibban, that Rasulullah said, you will give the right to the one who should have it. All the rights at the day of judgment. Justice will be done. Not only between the human being, even if you do wrong to the animals. And even an animal do wrong to another animal. Justice will be even between that. Listen to the hadith, حتى يقعد للشاة الجلحاء من الشاة القرناء. Until we with this retaliation, this qasas, this justice will be done between the two goats. The one who have a two horn, hit the one does not have. Will be taken justice and done justice between them. For the human being with the animals. You know hadith of Rasulullah? When a woman put cat in a cage and lock until die, Rasulullah said she will go to Jahannam. Why? Because she does not feed it. At the same time, she does not release it to eat by itself. Justice will be done even for something like that. For that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam teach us a dua very comprehensive. Dua very beautiful. Everyone should learn it. Allahumma inni a'udhu bika an adil aw udal. Oh Allah, I seek refuge with you. Oh Allah, save me, protect me from an adil, from being myself going astray by my own desire, going astray. أو أضل or others make me to go astray. أو أذل أو أذل. Oh Allah, save me from being submissive by my own self or submissive by the others. When they have a power against you, then they submissive you. When they do wrong against you. أو the point related to our topic, ظل أو أظلم أو أظلم. Oh Allah, I seek refuge with you from being oppressor or being oppressed. From being ظالم, doing wrong against other, or being also مظلوم, because both of them is wrong. Being مظلوم means the wrong done against me. أو أجهل أو يجهل علي. Oh Allah, I seek refuge with you from being جاهل and spread my جهل to others, or others do their جهل upon me. So beautiful. Oh Allah, save me from being أن أضل أو أضل أو أذل أو أذل أو أجهل أو يجهل علي أو أظلم أو أظلم. And there is many other du'a to the same to Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. For that, what is the advice of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم? Narrated by Tayalisi wa Ahmad wa al-Bukhari wa Tirmizi 2534 wa Ibn Hibban عن أبي هريرة Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, من كانت لأخيه عنده مظلمة من عرض أو مال فليتحلله اليوم قبل أن يؤخذ منه يوم لا دينار ولا درهم فإن كان له عمل صالح أخذ منه بقدر المظلمة وإن لم يكن له أخذ من سيئاته فجعلت عليه. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم say, if your brother have any right upon you, give it to him in the dunya, or at least ask him to forgive you in the dunya. Before the day of judgment, you will never be able to do except hasanat wa sayyat, good deeds and bad deeds. You will never be able to do. Apologize to him at the day of Qiyamah, it will never fail. Listen to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Himself used to ask Allah, oh Allah, I seek refuge with you, and I love, actually saying, I love to meet you and nobody have right upon me. I love to meet you and nobody have right upon me. He should take it from me. Listen to the hadith narrated by Imam Ahmad wa Abu Dawood 3433 والبيهقي قال إنما قال رسول الله إنما يرفع الله ويخفضه. In hand of Allah to raise somebody up or to put him down. وإني لأرجو أن ألقى الله وليس لأحد عندي مظلمة. I hope and I wish and I love to meet Allah and nobody have any right upon me at the day of judgment. This is what you should do and this is what you should say. I hope and I love and I wish, oh Allah, make me to meet you pure completely. Have no one have any right upon me. In another hadith of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, when Allah revealed, الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَلَمْ يَلْبِسُوا إِيمَانَهُمْ بِظُلْمٍ. Those who believe and does not mix their iman with any kind of ظلم. فشق ذلك على أصحاب النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. It was hard upon them, upon the Sahaba. Who of us is a believer and he does not commit some mistakes? They understand it this way. فقالوا يا رسول الله أينا لا يظلم نفسه. Who of us will not do wrong against himself? Sometimes committing some small mistakes. فقال ليس كما تظنون. رسول الله said, it is not like what you think. It is كما قال لقمان لابنه يا بني لا تشرك بالله إن الشرك لظلم عظيم. He said, this ayah means that do not commit shirk, because shirk is a great ظلم. For that here Allah say, ولم يلبسوا إيمانهم بظلم. They do not mix their iman with shirk. ظلم in this ayah was a shirk. In Al-Bukhari 3360, that Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم mentioned three different kinds of ظلم. قال الظلم ثلاثة. ظلم is a three different kind. ظلم لا يغفره الله. A ظلم and oppression and wrong will never be forgiven. And the second one, الظلم الذي يغفره الله. ظلم that Allah will forgive it. The third one, الظلم الذي لا يتركه الله. ظلم which Allah will never leave it. Then Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, فأما الظلم الذي لا يغفره الله, The ظلم which never be forgiven by Allah, الشرك. Committing any kind of shirk, associating with Allah anything in ibadah, in dua, in salah, in zakah, in siyam, in show off. Show off is kind of shirk. For that this is, Allah said, إِنَّ الشِّرْكَ لَظُلْمٌ عَظِيمٌ. It is a very major shirk. And in another ayah قال, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَغْفِرُ أَنْ يُشْرَكَ بِهِ. Allah will never forgive any kind of shirk. This is the one of kind of ظلم will never be forgiven. The one will be forgiven. فظلم العباد أنفسهم فيما بينهم وبين الله. When you commit wrong, but only between you and Allah. This is kind of ظلم. Like you neglect some of the salah, this is between you and Allah. When you neglect some of the zakah, between you and Allah. When you are able to do hajj, and you did not do, this is kind of ظلم. Kind of wrong. But against your own self, and this is between you and Allah. This is, it is up to Allah. If he wants, he will forgive it. If he doesn't want, he will punish you for it. The third kind, which Allah will never leave it, ظلم العباد بعضهم لبعض. When you commit any wrong against the others. حتى ينتصر لبعضهم من بعض. Until Allah will take the right from you to the one you do wrong against him. For that one will never be forgiven, shirk. One will be forgiven, which it is between you and Allah. One will never be leaving. Allah will not leave it, which it is between you and other people. Until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala takes the right of the others for them. And part of it also, and for our own Muslim people here, when you go to the court, حكم القاضي لك لا يعفيك أبدا إذا كنت تعلم أن هذا ليس من حقك. If the court already decide for you, and especially for the sisters, then this is, will never be, and you know that this is not your right in Islam. But you will be so happy that the court already decided for you in front of Allah Azza wa Jalla will be taken from you. Again, when you know that this is not your right, even decided to you, doesn't matter by who. Rasulullah himself say, even by me. Do not take it. Listen. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم, إنما أنا بشر مثلكم. I am a human being like any one of you. وإنما يأتيني الخصم. If two people coming for to judge in between them. فلعل بعضهم أن يكون أبلغ من بعض. Maybe one of them will have يعني a way of talking better and a way of explaining stronger than the other one. فأحسب أنه صادق فأقضي له. And I will think that he is saying the truth, means he lied. Then I will judge for him. فمن قضيت له بحق مسلم أي آخر فإنما هي قطعة من نار فليحملها أو يذرها. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم saying that if I judge for you and you know that it is not your right, and you know that it is the Muslim, the right of the other Muslim, then it is a part of Jahannam. I judge for you a part of from hellfire. Either you accept it, you take it, then you will go to hellfire, or you leave it. And this will apply for, this is Rasulullah, then will apply for everything. What about the judge himself? In the Tirmidhi 1337, وَأَبُوْ يَعْلَى وَابْنِ حِبَّانُ وَالطَّبَرَانِ عن ابن عمر رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم سيد من كان قاضيا فقضى بجور كان من أهل النار. Whoever was a judge doesn't mean only the one in the court. If you judge between any people, doesn't matter who are they. Even you are not a judge, but you put in a place of judging between people, then now this title of قاضي or قاضي will be upon you. And you do with jur means injustice. Not fair. كان من أهل النار. He will be one of the people of the hellfire. ومن كان قاضيا فقضى بجهل كان من أهل النار. If he judged between the people but by ignorance, his own desire. He leaves the right and but his own desire of jahl. Ignorant. Then he will be one of the hellfire people. ومن كان قاضيا فقضى بعدل فبالحري أن ينفلت كفافا. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم saying whoever being a judge then he does justice. رسول الله say فبالحري أن ينفلت كفافا means he will be coming out of it, no sin upon him and no reward for him. He will be كفافا means it is balanced for him, will be balanced for him. Listen to the other hadith of Abu Dawood 3556
وابن ماجة والحاكم عن بريدة رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم سي القضاة ثلاثة the judge is a three different kind اثنان في النار two of them will be in جهنم وواحد في الجنة an only one will be in جنة who the one in جنة رجل علم الحق فقضى به فهو الجنة فهو في الجنة a judge he knows the truth and he judge according to it he knows the truth and he knows the right and he do the justice and he do according to the justice then he will be in الجنة second one ورجل قضى للناس على جهل فهو في النار a judge judges the people by ignorant anything other than the Quran and Sunnah for that he will be جهنم والعياذ بالله number three ورجل جار في الحكم فهو في النار he do injustice then he will be in جهنم injustice here it could be he knows the truth and he knows the justice and who knows the right and he is not ignorant but he is still doing wrong injustice then he will be in جهنم والعياذ بالله another different kind of ظلم also because the topic about ظلم and whatever going on everywhere whatever happening in the school in Pakistan ظلم and not only in Pakistan this is because of the media they make it and they show it to us by Allah everywhere not only in the countries in the communities in the masajid in everywhere ظلم now subhanallah covering everywhere everyone and everywhere and if it is not you do dua sincerely to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to save us and coming later inshallah what you should do what is the steps to do to prevent all of this otherwise it will be continuously until all of us will die and Allah bring better than us Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say what about if a rich man he borrowed some money before for some business for whatever and he is rich and he tried to delay it he doesn't want to pay or he want to obey but he delay argue not this week next week not this year the next year والعياذ بالله قال صلى الله عليه وسلم مطل الغني ظلم يحل عرضه وعقوبته delaying while you are able is a kind of ظلم delaying to obey the loan or the money or the property or the house or the car or whatever it apply to everything Rasulullah's word is so comprehensive and general under it a lot for that sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say it is a kind of ظلم if you are able to do and you are not يحل عرضه وعقوبته it will make his backbiting halal to say to the people that this man is a ظالم he is able to obey and he does not وعقوبته but not by you عقوبته means punishing him but not by you by the one who is responsible for that the judge or the leader or whatever And listen to hadith in Bukhari 5,953 and 7,559 and in Imam Muslim al-Bayhaqi عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال الله عز وجل ونسيت قال الله it is hadith قدسي قال ومن أظلم ممن ذهب يخلق كخلقي من أظلم the most ظالم one the most wrongdoer one the most oppressor is the one who try to create something like the creation of Allah. Statues. If your house have any statues, get rid of it. Shayateen. Live in it. And it is forbidden. Angel will never enter. Jibril said to Rasulullah, لا ندخل بيتا فيه تمثال أو كلب. We will never enter a house. Have a statue. Statue of the original of it have a soul. Like a statue of a lion, statue of a human being, statue of anything have a soul, the life one. These kind of things, it prevents the angel from entering your house. Or a dog. Except the dog of كلب معلم للحراسة والصيد. Trained dog for guarding but not inside the house. For guarding and for hunting. This is the only one can be allowed for you. But because of the hair and because of the beauty, And this is a small and this is big. All of this garbage. Two qirat of all of your good deeds. I'm saying that because some of the Muslim have. توقي راد اوف اول اوف يور جود ديدز افري داي ويل بي ديكريزد. لا حول ولا قوه الا بالله. يو هاف ات ايذر فور تريند وان من معلم از الله وما علمتم من الجوارح مكلبين. الكلاب المعلمه. The dog if it's trained and knows for guarding and for hunting. These two only. And guarding or hunting, not inside. Should be in your backyard or outside or somewhere. This is your responsibility. Here Rasulullah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, whoever try to create something like the creation of Allah, قال الله عز وجل challenging them. I challenge them. فليخلقوا حبة أو يخلقوا ذرة أو يخلقوا شعيرة. والحديث الواحد كثيرة. He said, I challenge all of them or any one of them to create even a smallest thing, a wheat grain or a barley grain, and they will never be able. وفي رواية وذرة معنى نملة. وذرة بمعنى also smallest thing. This is kind of ظلم also, statues. Kind of another ظلم when you take the land of somebody else. Narrated by Muslim, Abu Dawood, والإمام أحمد in Dawood 3229, قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من اقتطع أرضا ظلما لقي الله وهو عليه غضبان. Whoever taking any land of somebody else unjustly, doesn't buy it, and he does not give it to you, then unjustly he will meet Allah while Allah is angry upon him. This is one narration. In another narration, من أخذ من الأرض شيئا جاء يوم القيامة يحمل ترابها على رأسه إلى المحشر. Whoever taken any part of the land or piece of the land unjustly, he will come in front of Allah Azza wa Jal having the dirt of it over his head till the place of al-mahshar, the place of gathering the view. In narration of al-Bukhari 2452 and 2453 and 3198 and many others, that Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said من أخذ شيئا من الأرض بغير حقه أي ظلما خسف به يوم القيامة إلى سبع أرضين. Whoever taken any piece of the land of other people unjustly, Allah عز وجل saying and Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم say he will be sinking down and down and down and more in the land to the seven earth down. Not only that, narrated by سعيد بن زيد بن عمرو بن نفيل أن أروى بنت إذر أوس أور أنيس خاصمته في أرض. That سعيد بن زيد with Arwa, she said that he taken my land. فقال سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول من ظلم شبرا من الأرض بغير حقه طوقه من سبع أراضين يوم القيامة. Whoever taken any piece of the land of other one unjustly, it will be listened. Whoever takes that, even a span, that much, means like this. Even a span of the land of other one unjustly, his neck will be encircled with seven earth. His neck will be circled with seven earth at the day of judgment. And he was angry and he was feeling sad that she accused him with something he never do. فقال سعيد, he did dua against here, and this is with the coming inshallah. Be careful of the dua of the Muslim against you. قال سعيد اللهم إن كانت كاذبة. Oh Allah, you know that she's a liar. And if it is true that she's a liar, اللهم أعمي بصرها. Oh Allah, make her to be blind. واجعل قبرها في تلك الدار. And make this land her grave. She taken ظلم. And make this land her grave. Listen. قال الراوي سعيد بن زيد فرأيتها تلتمس الجدر. After that she become blind and she woke. And touching the wall in order to walk. تقول أصابتني دعوة سعيد. I get the dua of Sa'id against me. فبينما هي تمشي في الدار while she's walking inside this land or this house خرت في بئر فوقعت فيها فماتت فكانت قبرها. She fell down in a water well and she died in it and it was her grave. That means the dua of him completely. Then listen to Rasulullah in al-Bukhari وابو داود وابن ماجة والترمزي قال ثلاثة لا ترد دعوتهم. Three different kinds will never, their dua will never be rejected. Means will be accepted. الصائم حتى يفطر. The fasting one until he break his fast. والإمام العادل. The just imam or the just ruler. ودعوة المظلوم. The dua of the مظلوم against you. يرفعها الله فوق الغمام. الله will raise it over the sky. ويفتح لها أبواب السماء. All the gates of the sky will be open to it. ويقول الله عز وجل. الله عز وجل said, swear by his jalal. لأنصرنك ولو بعد حين. I'll give you victory and I'll give you help even after a while. واتقوا في رواية البخاري ومسلم وأبو داود والترمذي لما أرسل النبي معاذ إلى اليمن ونسند معاذ اليمن قال the first thing save yourself from the دعاء of the مظلوم فإنها ليس بينها وبين الله حجاب no veil between it and Allah سبحانه وتعالى إن ريجن في الحاكم فإنها تصعد إلى الله كأنها شرار it goes to Allah like the spark do you know the lightning how fast is it and in a few seconds the دعاء of the مظلوم goes to Allah like that so fast and nothing can be prevented In narration of Ahmad والطبراني عن أنس قال اتق دعوة المظلوم وإن كان كافرا even he's a kafir unbeliever فإنها ليس بينها وليس دونها حجاب nothing can be prevented In other narration for الإمام الأحمد قال فإن دعوة المظلوم مستجابة it is accepted وإن كان فاجرا even he's the most wicked and evil one وإن كان فاجرا ففجوره على نفسه ودعاه عليك فجوره means his evil and his wicked will be against him not against you but his dua will come to you and will be accepted by Allah against you أقول قولي هذا وأدعو الله وأنتم موقنون الحمد لله رب العالمين وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول الحق تبارك وتعالى في سورة المائدة في الآية الثامنة الله عز وجل في سورة المائدة in verse number 8 ولا يجرمنكم شنان قوم على ألا تعدلوا اعدلوا هو أقرب للتقوى even you hate somebody even you don't like him even he's your enemy and come to justice and come to be witness and come to do the right do the justice do the good Otherwise will be against you. Listen to what Allah say. Let not the enmity and hatred. Do not let the enmity and hatred of other one make you to avoid the justice. Never make that hatred. Never make the enmity to make you avoid the justice. Means do the justice. Allah said, "Ya'dilu, be just. That is nearer to taqwa. That means when you are doing unjust, you are far away from taqwa. More inshallah about it and especially about what you should do if somebody is zalim and also about if you help a zalim what is your punishment and what is the superiority of forgiving if you are mazloom what is the superiority of forgiving if you are mazloom and also if somebody cuts a relation with you and if somebody prevent you and if somebody does not himself forgive you then you forgive him More about that, and more about also, inshallah, in the future, about different kind of dhulm and the harming of the dhulm to the communities and to the individual and to the whole earth. Allahumma kaffir lana dhunubana. Allahumma kaffir anna sayyatina. Allahumma tawaffana ma'al abrar. اللهم أرحنا وافرحنا واسترنا ولا تفضحنا. اللهم إنا نسألك باسمك الأعظم الذي إذا دعيت به أجبت وإذا سئلت به أعطيت. وإذا استرحمت به رحمت ارحم أموات المسلمين أجمعين اللهم ارحم أمواتنا وأموات المسلمين أجمعين اللهم اغفر لهؤلاء الذين قتلوا في باكستان اللهم اغفر لهم وارحمهم يا رب العالمين ونعوذ بك من الظلم أهله يا ذا الجلال والإكرام اللهم ارحمنا وارحمهم وارحم كل ما أموات المسلمين أجمعين اللهم إنا نسألك باسمك الأعظم الذي إذا دعيت به أجبت اجعلنا وأهالينا وبلادنا وبلاد المسلمين في ضمانك وأمانك وإحسانك وحفظك ورعايتك ونصرك وتأييدك يا ذا الجلال والإكرام وانصر من نصرنا واخذل من خذلنا واهدنا واهد بنا واجعلنا سببا لمن اهتدى وأعنا على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك يا حي يا قيوم اللهم إنا نسألك باسمك الأعظم الهدى والتقى والعفاف والغنى واغننا بحلالك عن حرام وبطاعتك عن معصيتك وبفضلك عمن سواك لا إله إلا الله الحليم الكريم لا إله إلا الله رب العرش العظيم لا إله إلا الله رب السماوات ورب الأرض ورب العرش الكريم الله الله ربي لا أشرك به شيئا اللهم اغفر لنا وارحمنا وعافنا واعف عنا وعلى طاعتك عنا أن أولوز إن شاء الله remember me in your دعاء وجزاكم الله خيرا